that government will continue to enhance the capacity and capability of the police, both in terms of hardware, training, and numbers, to equip and empower them to discharge their duty of making our country safe through increased patrols, greater mobility, and visibility. Two, government will strongly support the police in a campaign to vigorously pursue and to directly confront and disable criminal elements wherever they may be. Nowhere must be safe for them, and this campaign will be sustained for as long as is necessary. Let me inform you that that campaign has already started, and in the last few months we have invested well over $3 million in the police force to further equip them and to prepare them for this battle in our society. This year, in the coming financial year, already we have identified the need to further improve on the police force, and an amount of well over $9 million will be allocated to improving the resources and the capability of the police force. The third point was that government will continue to seek and obtain technical and material assistance from friendly governments and collaborate with our regional and sub-regional neighbors to address crime and security issues, including the protection of our borders. On this matter, St. Lucia has proposed the establishment of a regional security force, police force, to work through the OECS, exchanging from island to island, providing police services in the OECS. The fourth point is that government will strengthen existing legislation and introduce new ones where necessary in consultation with the judiciary and legal systems, and seek the support of the relevant institutions in ensuring enforcement. Fifth, that government will implement a program of social reform and renewal targeting all areas, and particularly inner city communities and youth. And finally, the sixth point was that government will engage in the widest possible consultative approach with all sectors of the society on strategies for confronting the crime and security challenges facing our country. This will include the convening of a joint session of Parliament, which will be specifically geared to addressing crime and security. This joint session of the Parliament is scheduled for the 5th April next month. In the last few months, government has restructured and strengthened the senior management of the police and have provided them with the necessary hardware and human resources to bolster their capacity to execute their mandate to protect citizens of our country. In addition, the government of Israel has approved a request from the government of St. Lucia to provide assistance to the local police in the following areas. One, intelligence gathering and handling human resources. Two, operations and detective work. And three, technical surveillance and general surveillance. Representation has also been made to the government of the United States of America for additional training and logistics, to which they have already responded. The Attorney General and Minister for Justice has announced some of the areas where government intend to improve on legislation and to strengthen and implement new legislation. Some of these are now going through the parliamentary approval process. Much has been said about the social dimensions of crime, but let me reassure you as St. Lucians that social reform has been and continues to be at the center of government's development agenda. This agenda includes the implementation of various social programs, employment generation, and youth empowerment. Recently, I received a proposal from the head of the Roman Catholic Church in St. Lucia, Archbishop Robert Rivers, proposing an Action for Peace program, which I fully embrace and look forward to working with the church and all other religious groups in the interest of removing this threat to our society. Indeed, the business of resolving the crime problem is everybody's business, from the individual to the family, the schools, the churches, to the business community, NGOs, and civil society. We all must partner with government in our efforts to uproot and bring an end to this scourge. It is our responsibility, and we must not fail in our resolve to deal with this problem. In the immediate term, there is a need for all St. Lucians to rally together as a community and as a nation against all forms of criminal activity. Criminality is criminality, and therefore we must stamp criminality once and for all. I will not be contented as Prime Minister if ever I were to fail during my tenure in office to bring crime under control and secure our country and declare it as the safest place in the entire Caribbean. Thank you. The mission that the police force has to undertake the job at hand is not an easy one, so I have called for the cooperation of all citizens in that regard. I'm aware that there are those who will, and they have already, criticized certain actions of the police, as they are likely to have collateral damage at times, but the government will not rest until we have uprooted the criminal elements and restore peace and tranquility to our country. Let me assure you that I will not let up in my resolve to make Fair Helen a peaceful and safe society once again. My government stands completely together with all law-abiding citizens of St. Lucia and supports our police in its campaign to restore law and order to the land. On this note, let me indicate that ever since the heightened activities and operations of the police, we have seen some 7 fatalities as a consequence of police operations. There are some complaints within the community, but it's certainly unfortunate that in such operations that there will always be collateral damage. Ever since the police commenced its operations, in the last 4 weeks, we have recorded 0 murders in St. Lucia. Fellow St. Lucians, I'm sure you will agree that the year 2010 was very challenging for many of us as individuals and for our nation as a whole. This government can boast of its record. We have been able to maintain economic stability in the face of an international recession, a debilitating drought, and severe damage caused by a hurricane. We have followed the media reports of massive job losses and foreclosures in the developed world. We have heard the stories of individuals folding up, of industries folding up, and economic upheavals. In St. Lucia, we've been able to avoid these shocks while safeguarding the gains we have made since achieving nationhood 32 years ago. Indeed, We have avoided massive layoffs and job losses. Our ability to maintain stability during a period of very trying domestic and international challenges has positioned our economy to benefit from any economic upswing which might be expected as the world climbs out of this economic recession. Fellow St. Lucians, notwithstanding the recent challenges and adversities, we can face 2011 with confidence as we embrace this year and the task of rebuilding St. Lucia in a post-Tomas era. We do so with confidence and pride in our determination to succeed and to exceed previously realized gains, both personally and nationally. The government will continue to provide strong and insightful leadership. Government is committed to creating an enabling environment within which each St. Lucian can realize his or her hopes and expectations, and at the same time, provide opportunities to youth St. Lucians overseas willing to return home to contribute to your native land. On behalf of my cabinet and the government and people of St. Lucia, I wish all of you God's blessings, hoping that we shall bask in the improvements likely in our social and economic status this year and beyond. I thank you.